Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I've decided to do something a bit more fun to ease the path, so to say. And we're going to be doing some sort of thing that people generally do for April Fool or something of a kind. Basically, you get to modify the browsing information of anybody that you can spoof, whose ARP you can spoof. And what this means is that you can actually affect how they view websites. For example, you can flip their images, you can flip all images on a website upside down, or you can insert text, or perhaps you can add extra words to Google search, or I don't know, you can do some crazy things like change language settings to something ridiculous, like there are these fictional languages. Something from Star Trek, I do believe that I found it on the net, a small script that actually changes your language settings to Klingon while browsing the internet. Can you just imagine reading anything, trying to read something, or trying to translate it back or something of a kind? That wouldn't really be fun. Anyway, even though this is primarily for fun, this part anyway, you still of course would need a permission unless you are on your own wireless or something of a kind. Anyway, let's just go. I have a small instruction script for myself here, just so that I don't mess anything up during this procedure. I have already done it, and it seems to work to a good extent. Some of the scripts, they won't always work, but good amount of the time you will be able to achieve what you want. Anyway, first of all, we need something called Squid, and Squid is a proxy, so let me just show you. Apt cache search Squid, and I'm gonna say 3. Also, you might have noticed that I am back in Kali Linux. And Kali Linux comes with a lot of these tools pre-installed, so I don't need to go through a lot of hassle or something like that. And the configuration is a bit simpler as you have a setup predefined here. Also, I don't need direct access to wireless for this sort of an attack. Anyway, we're gonna need to install Squid. You can see here Squid 3. Full featured web proxy cache HTTP proxy. In order to install it, oops, not yum, type in apt-get install and then squid3 space dash y, press enter, and this will install it. I'm not going to press enter now because I already have it installed. That is one of the tools which we are going to need, but there is more. You will need Apache web server for this, so again with the apt-get search, and we're gonna need Apache. Apache is a well-known, oops, it's not get, it's Apache, sorry. Apache is a well-known web server used by the majority of the world today. I don't know what percentage of user actually uses Apache, but lately there were some other web servers which became really popular. For example, Nginx, that's one that gained on popularity really fast. It's apparently a lot faster. I can't find the exact name of the package here, but it doesn't really matter. Look, just type in yum and oops again. Just type in apt-get install Apache 2, press enter, and there you go. It says that Apache 2 is already the newest version, and doesn't really, oh wait, I need 62 upgrades, doesn't matter, I'm not going to do any of the upgrades now. But anyway, this is the command to install it. Apache 2 is the name of the package. I could have found it in the list up there, but figured I would just save some time and give you the direct command for you to install it so that we don't have too much of a time loss there. Anyway, go ahead and clear the screen. The next thing that you're going to need is a bunch of scripts, and I do believe I have them here. No, not these scripts. Where do you suppose they are? Well, okay, I do have them, but they're on my clipboard. Okay, so it's apt-get-y install, and you need these three programs. So image magic ghost script and JP2A. I've written for myself here ghost script optional. You will only need ghost scripts for certain scripts that we're gonna download from the net. Not sure exactly which ones, but you can just install it. It doesn't take a lot of space and it doesn't take a lot of time. Let me just see if I have all of them installed. And yes, I do have all three of them installed here, so no problems there. But if you don't, just go ahead and run the same command, of course, and you will have it installed, no problems. Just go ahead and clear the screen. Anyway, those three tools we are going to need in order to actually perform this attack. So let's just go over them one more time. It's Squid, Apache, and these last three scripts that I have showed you, that not three scripts, sorry, I keep on calling them scripts. They're script in, well, this one is a script interpreter. And this is actually just, I don't know, this is just a program for manipulating images on the web or something of a kind. Anyway, so these three as well, and then we will be able to perform this attack. Make sure that you have them all installed. You don't need to configure anything. We will do the configuration in the next tutorial, but make sure that you have all three of them installed before you start watching the next tutorial, because there I will actually go into the configuration and we will see what we need to do in order to prepare some of the things we've already done if you've kept the configuration from the previous tutorials. But if not, you're gonna need to do a few things here. Anyway, I bid you all farewell and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.